tonight to discuss what is visceral manipulation. Visceral manipulation is a manual therapy technique that was developed by French osteopath Jean-Pierre Barral. Barral decided to take a look at the visceral structures, or internal organs, and how they are players in pain and dysfunction. You may be wondering, how can we do this? Or why would we be interested in looking at these structures as key players in pain and functional inefficiency? First of all, I think it's important for us to recognize that everything has to have movement in order to have good health. It's easy for us to conceptualize our muscles and bones moving when we lift our arm or when we lift our leg, but our organs also have movement. We can think of our heart pumping, our lungs pumping, our digestive system working. All of those organs have a natural movement within themselves, and they work with the other organs and the other structures within our body to create this harmonious movement system. Whenever somebody has trauma, if they've undergone a surgery, they have chronic inflammation, they have implants from a mesh, hernia mesh, all those things create tensions within our system and adhesions that lead to dysfunctional movement patterns. Say, for instance, I had my appendix removed. That would be all this scar tissue down here in my right lower quadrant. So if I went to lift my arm, I might not be able to lift my arm efficiently due to all of that scar tissue down there, or some adherence on the surrounding visceral structures. The body has endless variety of motion, and it's important for us as therapists to tease out the systems that are creating those movement dysfunctions. Maybe you've had unsuccessful PT in the past. Maybe you've been seeing a practitioner for chronic hip pain that's not getting better. Maybe they've constantly worked on your hip flexor. You're still not reaching that PR in your marathon. You're not able to perform as well as you would like. Are you still having chronic pain? Maybe the reason for that isn't your hip flexor. Maybe it's an adhered cecum or an ovary or some other visceral structure. I think it's important to look for a practitioner that's not only looking at the container, but the contents within the container and how that relates to pain and dysfunction. Here at Beyond Basics, we are happy to help. We look forward to seeing you soon.